Hello students, welcome to maths class. Hope you remember in our previous class I have started fractions chapter where we discussed about fractions and types of fractions. Tell me, what are the types of fractions, students? The types of fractions are proper fractions, improper fractions and mixed fractions. Later we learned about like, unlike and equivalent fractions. There I have told you how to find equivalent fractions of a given fraction. Let's solve some more examples on that. See here, example 1, find equivalent fractions of 2 by 3 by multiplication. Here we have to find equivalent fractions of 2 by 3 by using multiplication. So what is our first step? We have to choose a positive number. I am taking here 4, which you have to multiply to both numerator as well as denominator of a given fraction. Let's write here. First, you have to write the given fraction. And for that, you have to multiply the number which you have chosen. I am taking here 4. Multiply to 4, and the same number you have to multiply to the denominator. So what we get here? 2 into 4, we get 8. Upon 3 into 4, we get 12. Therefore, 8 by 12 is an equivalent fraction of 2 by 3. Similarly, you can find equivalent fraction of 8 by 12. Choose a number and multiply to both numerator and denominator. Here I am taking 2. Multiply these 2 to the numerator 8 as well as the denominator 12. So we get 8 into 2, we get 16, upon 12 into 2, we get 24. Therefore, 16 by 24 is an equivalent fraction of 8 by 12. It is also an equivalent fraction of 2 by 3. All of these are equivalent fractions. Remember, for a given fraction, you can find many number of equivalent fractions. Let's solve example 2. See here, find equivalent fractions of 10 by 20 by division. Here also you have to find equivalent fractions of 10 by 20, but here you have to use division. Write the given fraction first, 10 by 20. Here you have to be careful while choosing a number, because here we are using division. You have to choose a number in such a way that both the numerator as well as denominator should be divided by the same number. So I am taking here 2. Now divide the numerator by 2 and denominator by 2. So we will get 10 by 2. We get 5. Upon 20 by 2, we get 10. So this is an equivalent fraction of 10 by 20. Similarly, you can find equivalent fraction of 5 by 10 also, because here we can use 5 to divide numerator as well as denominator. Use it. 5 divided by 5 upon 10 divided by 5. So we will get here 5 by 5, get 1, upon 10 divided by 5, get 2. Therefore, 1 by 2 is an equivalent fraction of 5 by 10, and also it is an equivalent fraction of 10 by 20. All of these are equivalent fractions. Let's solve a few more examples. See here, example 3. Fill in the boxes. In 2 by 15, it is equal to 4 by dash, it is equal to dash by 45. Here, you have to fill these boxes with your answer. See here, for that, you have to compare these two equivalent fractions. 2 by 15, which is equal to 4 by dash. See here, the numerator, just observe the numerators here. Here we have 2 and here we have 4. Which number you are going to multiply to this 2 to get 4? 2. We know that 2 2s are 4. The same number you have to multiply to this denominator to fill this box. Let's solve it. See here, we have 2 by 15. So, which number you are going to multiply this 2 to get this 4? We have to multiply 2 only. The same number you have to multiply to the denominator. So, you will get 2 2's are 4 upon 15 2's are 30. Therefore, 4 by 30 is an equivalent fraction of 2 by 15. So, this is our first answer, 30. In the same way, now see here, to fill this box, you have to compare this fraction with 2 by 15. Now, here you have to compare the denominators. 15 here we have and here we have 45. These two fractions you have to compare to fill this box. Now tell me, 15 how much are 45? 15 3s are 45. So, the same number you have to multiply to the numerator also to fill this box. Now, see here, write 2 by 15. So, 15 how much are 45? It's 3. Multiply that 3 to the numerator as well as the denominator. So, you will get 2 3s are 6 upon 15 3s are 45. Therefore, 6 by 45 is an equivalent fraction of 2 by 15. Here, our answer is 6. Let's solve example 4. See here, write an equivalent fraction of 3 by 5 in which the first condition, numerator is 9 and the second condition, denominator is 20. Here you have to find equivalent fraction of 3 by 5. But here we have two conditions. In the first condition, numerator should be 9 and in the second condition, denominator should be 20. Let's solve for the first condition. For that, you have to write the given fraction. Write the given fraction, that is 3 by 5. So, the condition is numerator should be 9. Which is numerator here? 3. Which number you are going to multiply to this 3 to get 9? 3 how much are 9? 3 3s are 9. So, that number you have to multiply to the numerator as well as denominator. Multiply 3 into 3 and the same number we have to multiply to the denominator 5, which is equal to 3 3s are 9 upon 5 3s are 15. Therefore, 9 by 50 is an equivalent fraction of 3 by 5 where the numerator is 9. Let's solve for the second condition. For that also, you have to write the given fraction first.
Write the given fraction 3 by 5.
Now see here, the condition is denominator should be 20. What is the denominator here? We have 5. 5, how much are 20? 5, 4s are 20. So you have to multiply that 4 to the numerator as well as the denominator. Multiply it. 3, 4s are 12 upon 5, 4s are 20. Therefore, 12 by 20 is an equivalent fraction of 3 by 5, where our denominator is 20. Hope the concept is clear. So our next concept is reducing a fraction to its lowest term or simplest form. What do you mean by lowest term or a simplest form? When fraction is said to be in its lowest term or in simplest form? See, a fraction is said to be in its lowest term when numerator and denominator have no common factor except 1. For example, see here,
1 by 9.
Here, numerator is 1 and the denominator is 9. Is there any common factor between them? No. Means we can't use a same number to divide 1 and 9. They don't have any common factor. These type of fractions are known as the fractions in their lowest term or fractions in their simplest form. And also
2 by 3,
is it in its lowest term? Yes, because we can't use a number to divide 2 and 3, or they don't have any common factor except 1. Now tell me,
10 by 5,
is it in its lowest term? No. Why? Because we can use 5 to divide 10 and 5. So this is not in its lowest term. If you divide it by 5,
if you divide it by 5, then you will get here 2 by 1, which is nothing but the fraction in its lowest term.
So the fraction is said to be in lowest term when numerator and denominator have no common factor except 1. Now students, let us understand the concept in better way by solving some examples. See here, example 1. Convert 18 by 48 into its lowest terms. We have to convert 18 by 48 into its lowest terms. For that, you have to find the factors of 18 and 48. I'll show you how we have to find the factors of 18. Write 18 and here you have to divide it with a small numbers. Now, 18. Which number you are going to take to divide 18? 2. Because we know that 2, how much are 18? 2, 9s are 18. Yes. Again, you have to divide this 9. Which number you are going to take now? Yes, 3.
3s are 9. 3, how much are 9 students?
3, 3s are 9. Here we have 3, divide it with 3 only. So 3, 1s are 3. Here you have to stop. When you get 1, you have to stop factorization. Therefore, after this, 18 can be written as 2 into 3 into 3. 18 can be written as 2 into 3 into 3. These are the factors of 18. Similarly, you have to find the factors of 48. For that, write 48 and start dividing it. with the, which number you are going to take here? 2. Take 2 and divide it. 2, how much is 4? 2 twos are 4. Now come to 8. 2, how much is 8? 2 fours are 8. Again you have to divide 24. I am taking here 2 because 24 is divisible by 2. Divide it. 2, how much are 24? 2, 1s are 2. And what about the 4? 2 2s are 4. Again divide 12 by 2. 2, how much are 12? It is 6. 2, 6 are 12. We can use 2 only to divide 6. So 2, 3s are 6. Now here we have 3. So 3 is divisible by 3 itself. 3, 1s are 3. So here we have to stop. Therefore 48 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, right? 48 is equals to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. So these are the factors of 48. After that you have to write the given fractions. 18 by 48, which is equal to, 18 can be written as here, 2 into 3 into 3, write it. 18 can be written as 2 into 3 into 3 upon 48 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3, write it here. 48 can be written as 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Now we have to divide the same number which is in numerator and denominator. The same number you have to cancel. See here. Here we have 2 and here also we have 2. Cancel them. And what about 3? Here I have 1, 3. Here also I have 1, 3. Get cancelled. What about this 3? Here in numerator I have a 3. What about the denominator? We don't have. So let it be. Which is equal to, now write the remaining terms. Here I have 3 only. And what about the denominator, students? We have 2 into 2 into 2. Which is equal to, in numerator we have 3. Write it as it is. 3 upon, in the denominator, see here, 2 into 2, 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, therefore we get 8. 3 by 8 is the lowest term or simplest form of 18 by 48. It is the simplest form of 18 by 48. Now, you can use another method to get the lowest term, which you have to use in your higher class. There you have to find the lowest term or simplest form very quickly. I'll show you that method also. See here, for that you have to write the given fraction. For that you have to write given fraction. I choose a number and that number should divide both numerator and denominator. I am taking here 2. 2 9s are 18. Now 48. 2 2s are 4. 2 4s are 8. So we are left with 9 by 24. Can we further divide it? Yes. Because 9 and 24 come under the table 3. Divide it again. 3, how much are?
3, 3 is a 9, 3, 8 is a 24. So, we get 3 by 8. See here. We get 3 by 8, which is the simplest form of 18 by 48. Try to solve the problems in this method also. So, 3 by 8 is the simplest form of 18 by 48, which we get by directly dividing it, which you have to use in your higher class. Let's solve one more example. Convert 99 by 66 into its lowest term. Here you have to convert 99 by 66 into its lowest term. For that, first you have to find the factors of 99. Find out the factors of 99. Which number you are going to take here? 3. Take 3 and divide it. 3, 3 is a 9. 3, 3 is a 9. Again, 3 again. 3, 1s are 3, 3 1s are 3. Which number you are going to take and divide 11? It's 11 itself, because 11 is divisible by itself only. 11, 1s are 11. Here you have to stop. Therefore, 99 can be written as 3 into 3 into 11. 3 into 3 into 11. Similarly, you have to find the factors of 66. Write 66 and find its factors. 66, which is divisible by 2. Yes. 2 how much are? 2 3s are 6. 2 3s are 6. Now divide 33. I'll take 3 here. 3 1s are 3. 3 1s are 3. And 11 is divisible by 11 itself. 11 1s are 11. Therefore, 66 can be written as 2 into 3 into 11. After that, you have to write this fraction, which is 99 by 66, which is equal to 99 can be written as 3 into 3 into 11. Write it. 3 into 3 into 11 upon 66 can be written as 2 into 3 into 11. 2 into 3 into 11. What is your next step? You have to cancel the same number which are in numerator and denominator. Here I have 3. What about the denominator? We have 3 here also. Cancel them. 3, 3. What about this 3? We have 3 in numerator, but not in denominator. So, let it be. What about the 11? We have 11 in numerator as well as denominator. Cancel them. 11, 11 get cancelled. So, we are left with 3 in numerator and 2 in the denominator. Therefore, 3 by 2 is the lowest term or simplest form of 99 by 66. Let's find the lowest term of 99 by 66 by direct division. Choose a number and divide them. I'm taking 11 here. 11, how much are 11? 9s are, you know that. 11, how much are 66? 11, 6 are. So we are left with 9 by 6. Can we further divide it? Yes, because 9 and 6 come under the table 3. Divide them. 3, 3s are 9, 3, 2s are 6. Therefore, 3 by 2, which is the lowest term of 99 by 66. Hope the concept is clear. I have attached homework problem with this video. Solve them in your maths notebook. Let's meet in our next class. Till then, be safe, be happy, keep learning. Thank you.